we are going to be getting back into some Star Wars Jedi
we
Knight
Academy. We are
going to
be
getting
Academy.
Back into some... So, I'm going to share this out a couple places, and then we'll get started. For people who joined in the Den Time, it was really awesome. You guys should definitely come and check out the Den Times. It's a time when I do my nightly vlog, talk about the day, what games played, upcoming things, like events, like the collab that's going to be happening at the end of the month. And there's a countdown timer on the page, and that's what that countdown timer is for. So, it's also, if you guys have a question for me, it's a great time to ask me a question, because that's kind of what that Den Time is there for. It's there for you guys to actually ask me questions. So, I don't mind answering questions when I'm streaming a game. That being said, I do try and ask that you guys keep any questions respectful and relevant. And what I mean relevant, I mean like relevant to like asking me about the game, asking me about the slideshow that's going on in the top right corner, the things that I like to do, things that Indigo likes to do, things that my brother-in-law likes to do, things, again, just relevant questions, things that have relevance to them. I got to be honest, I'm a little annoyed that I even have to put that disclaimer there. But over the last couple Den Times, and honestly into some other videos, I've gotten some highly inappropriate questions and or comments. And been a bit upset about it. So that's why I'm saying something about it, is because unfortunately I have gotten inappropriate stuff, and I just don't tolerate it. So I hate to be a little bit of a downer to start with. Okay. I put in some overlays just to kind of see, and I need to disable those because that's going to create a major issue. I'll get to that here in a minute. All right, so I want to edit and remove extension. Those are fine. The schedule needs to disappear. Okay. I may end up just removing all three for the time being. Okay. I thought I dealt with all of those. Technically, they're under something. So let's go here and here. Deactivate for the time being. Okay, let's see if that took care of what I hope it would. There we go. Okay. So, yeah, that's fine. I can deal with the rest of that later. All right, let's get into the game. I've pussyfooted around enough. So, all right. And hopefully the game doesn't freak out on me and I have to reload it. Got to the sand crawler, and now we're trying to figure out where we need to go from here. Evidently not that way. I thought I could jump off of it, I guess. Nikes. Having a little bit of a hard time. This game doesn't really do a run jump type thing per se. Thank you. I don't really have a map, so I don't know. If I... people got up to that upper deck, and I'm not entirely positive how they got up to that upper deck. One of the decks I can jump to, that's not an issue. But you would think there's a door or something that okay, so there's droid parts or something that's over there that I need to find a way to. So, let's see if there's another way for me to get over. That didn't work. Back up because we don't want to get blown to crap like we did last time. There is a way to get over there. Not... something like this, and there's like seem to find any way to get to it. It's just very, very frustrating. I mean, the graphic glitch is cool because it kind of helps you see a little bit, because it's like, it looks like there's something over to the right. So it kind of lends credence to maybe there's something. Yeah. Yeah. How you doing, Doxus? I hope that you're having a great day. What is this? is just gonna lead us back down. Well, yes and no. Okay. So here. Let's go back over to where the droid is and see if there's anything we can interact with as far as that goes. Nope. Looks like a dismantled protocol droid. I'd like to try and scout the rim of map, and then work my way inward. It usually, if I've got an actual map that I'm actually trying to fill in, it works really well because it helps me figure out where the ins and outs of a particular place are, so that if I'm looking at a map, I can go, okay, so I was here, and then. Unfortunately, I think this game really predates anything as far as maps go. Alright, I think this just let us back up. Pretty positive this let us back into which is pretty positive that's where we just came from. Yeah, that's where we just came from. Okay. So we started that way. Let's go this way.
I can't go that way.
That's fine. I get annoyed as far as going in circles. It seems to be what I do a lot. But circles in their own way do have their purposes because they help you kind of get your bearing. Like, okay, I was already here, so. Thank you. that, another moisture. Okay, so that's where we came from. Okay, so now that we've moderately got our bearings. Got my mouse set basically to max sensitivity in game settings. That's both a good thing and a bad thing. Hopefully I'm not wandering too much in circles. Well, just to be on the safe side, let's save. Because you never know, and too, I would hate to be in progress, so. End up back at the place again. I think what I'll do is I'll make my way to the wall. To the thermal deck. Can't even see it on the ground for me to grab, so that's always cool. Okay, so I said if I came back here, I would basically go into the wall where it said I can't go any further. And then backtrack from there. And a lot of that's actually just a memory trick. You intentionally go to a point of reference, and then you make your way from there to where you're trying to go. And it's a really good visual, it's a really good memory trick to use.
Cushy.
Because it gives you a consistent reference point from which to navigate from. And also by going a set way and then going like what I'm doing, you're also basically putting into your memory a particular pattern, and so when you're trying to retrace your steps or something like that, it's helpful because you go, okay, I already went up to here, and then from here I went over here. And it's just, it's a good way to do things. It really helps. Unless your short-term to long-term conversion, like mine, is shot. Which gives it doesn't always work. So we located the missing sand crawler. We need to eliminate the Tusken Raiders, and we need to retrieve the droid. Wrong sand crawler. Okay. So I have a feeling I missed the droid. Sandcrawler. downside to early games like this is they don't actually give you a map. Unfortunately, it's very much on your memory.
Unit. Can't go that way.
Okay, so this was a secret area. Fascinating. Okay. I thought they would have had under the crawler, so we're gonna check out this crawler. I know I've kinda already looked under the crawler once, but just to be on the... Actually, brings us to that. I've got this wall. There's part of me that feels like there's something about this wall that I need to. I tried blowing it up from the other side, and that did not work. So I definitely feel like I'm missing something. I'm not entirely positive what I'm missing, though. No. There's like a cave or a door or something. I'm not really sure. Nothing like going, I know I'm missing something, and then either A, constantly passing over and missing it, or going, you know you're missing something, it's probably positive what you're missing. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to call this episode good here. We'll just call it. So, anyways, thank you guys so much for watching. It's been a pleasure playing for you. We'll actually be doing some Star Wars Rebellion next. I need to... Excuse me. I need to, like, make some tea or something like that. But, again, thank you so much. If you're new to the channel, don't forget to hit that follow button up top. If you're looking for ways to support the channel, there's a donation link down below. Anyways, thank you guys so much. Until the next time, I'm Panther0822. Peace out, guys. I'll see you on the flip side.